Hello everyone, I'm here tonight. I'm going to be demonstrating installable triggers and using the event object to get value out of those installable triggers. A question was asked to me by a lady named Cheryl Brennan and about creating kind of an attendance tracker for a librarian, but she didn't want me to tell her exactly how to do it because she wants to experiment with AppScript on her own. So I thought of another way to demonstrate kind of a similar idea. And that's going to be with the Google Sheets form submit, which is another installable trigger, just a little bit different than the installable trigger for the forms submit. And you can read all about both of those in the documentation. But I've already created my kind of template for a club signup sheet. It's basically just a student name, student email, and then three choices for club activities. Basketball club, board game club, Quidditch club, and then a web development club. And all of that just gets fed into a spreadsheet. Well, on this spreadsheet is where we want to put our installable trigger. So I'm going to go ahead and fire this up and get started. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger so that everyone can see. That should be good. And we'll call this club signup sheet. And I don't need that much room for the name of the file. I'm going to just call this function form submit. And that takes in that event parameter. I'm going to call it E. And that's simply, we can just log that. We can just log that right here, save this, and go ahead and create the trigger from there. I've had some sort of graphical thing on my screen. I don't know why that is. You can also reach your project triggers. We're just going to current projects triggers, and we should have no triggers set up. So I'm going to add one. The only function I have is form submit, and we don't want it to be time driven. We want it to be from the spreadsheet. We don't want it on open. We want to change that to on form submit because there's a linked form. There's going to be a trigger that we can install, and let's get the permissions on here. Sign in from this account. And we want to allow it just to view and manage our spreadsheets. So when I go to this form and I submit, I'm going to just say Jordan, my email address, come, and I want web development. It's my first choice. I want Quidditch as a second, obviously. And board game is the third. Click submit, and we've got that popping up, and in the script we can see that log here, bunch of information, and I'll talk more about that in 1 second. The two valuable pieces of information that are in there, if I go back to the documentation, the valuable pieces of information in there are the values array, which is just an array. You know, zero index is the first column, so on and so forth. We can also get those values as an object with the key being the column name, which is also very helpful. I'm going to demonstrate both of them in this. But I want this to do a couple of things every time someone submits to the form. I want it to create different sheets for the different clubs that are available. And if the club isn't full, I want to add students to those sheets. If the club is full, I want it to then go to look at the second choice and then add the student to that sheet. And then so on and so forth. The third choice will get added. They'll add the student to that if, the first and second choices are full. So it basically is creating our club rosters for us, as students sign up. And there'll be probably some more ideas that we can add on this as we go, but I'm just going to go ahead and get started here. So I'm going to take from the event object. I want the first choice, I want the second choice, and I want the third choice. Got to declare these variables right at the beginning. I'm going to call this E, named values. And I want to get from the first choice and the zero index of that. If we look back at the documentation, you'll see in the named ranges key, the named ranges parameter, we've got these keys, and then the values are actually inside of arrays, so we actually have to refer to them with that index value. So I'm gonna do the same thing for both of these others. And instead of first choice, I want that to be second choice, and then third choice. Perfect. A couple other values that we're going to need here. We need the student's name. And I'm going to get this from the values array. We don't need to. We could also pull it from the named ranges, but I just want to show that it's possible. So from that values array, the email is in the second index, the two index. So the B column refers to the first index, and then C is the second index, emails. So there we go. Then we're going to actually have to test and see if those groups are full. I'm going to write out the expression, and then we're going to have to, we'll come back to it and fill out the information. Is group full? And then I want to test the first choice. Then else if, is group full? Second choice, is the second option available? And then if that's not available, we're going to do is group full, third choice. Now obviously this is group full does not exist, so we're going to create it down below. Function is group full, and then it's going to take in a parameter of the group name. And we want to do, we want to test if there is a sheet with that group's name. If there is, test if full. If there isn't, we want to just return false. And I don't know why I typed that in comments. I just want to return false if that sheet doesn't exist. So let's get the sheet. We need to make that a variable. Get var sheet equals spreadsheet app dot get active spreadsheet and get sheet by name, and we're going to put in that group name. So basically, if there is a sheet by that name, it's going to save it in this sheet variable. Otherwise, it's going to be undefined. So we're testing to see if it's undefined here. And if it's not, if it is undefined, it's going to return false automatically. If it is defined, we are going to return a ternary here. So we're going to do sheet.getDataRange.getValues. Get values, and then we're going to take the length of that, and we want to see if that's greater than or equal to 10. That's going to be our club size. If that's greater than or equal to 10, then we're going to return this true value. Otherwise, this is also going to be false. So in one line, we can pretty much test that whole thing. This is called these ternary operators. If you need to look up more about that, just do a Google search on JavaScript ternary operators, and you can find much better information. So we've got our function, is the group full? And actually, you know what we want to change here? So is group full is going to be returned to either a true or a false value. And we want, if it is true, if it is full, we want it to go to the next one. So we actually only want this to run. We want this block here to run only if this is negative. So this is false. So we need to test those are false. We can do that just with that exclamation point there. Sorry, made that a little too big. Okay, so that exclamation point tells us those things. Now inside of these, we're gonna write another if statement. And to do that, let's go ahead and create a spreadsheet variable because we're gonna be using this kind of a lot here. So spreadsheet app.get active spreadsheet. And we're just gonna save that to the variable SS. And if the SS.get sheet by name, first choice, then that means it does exist already, and we can just ss.get sheet by name first choice, and then we're going to append row, and that takes in just a simple array, and we're going to put the student name and the email into that array. Very simple. But if that sheet doesn't exist, it's going to give us an error. It's going to error out on us, so we actually have to create it. So that's the purpose of this if-else statement, just to kind of prevent us from erroring out. And we can actually just do spreadsheet, and we're going to insert sheet, and that just takes in the exact same variable, and then we're going to still append the row. Now, this little loop is going to be the same for each of these code blocks. So we're going to just copy and paste them in there. And we got to make just a few simple changes. Second choice, we want to go ahead and change all of these first choices to second choice. And then we want to get this third choice, make all these third choices. Boom. Now there is an easier way to do that. If you're watching this and you're a JavaScript wizard, probably like there's a much better way to do that. But for right now, we're just going to get this thing to work, and then we'll come back and we'll refactor a little bit, make this make the code a little cleaner. So let's go ahead and submit another response. And let me just add, I'm just going to use the name Steve, and this is going to be steve@gmail.com. And Steve likes Quidditch and then basketball. He's more athletic. And then board games. He's not interested in web development. So let's see here. We've got Steve popped up there. And you'll see that now I've got this extra sheet here. Quidditch Club has been created. A sheet with the names and email addresses of the people that have signed up for Quidditch Club. And then as more and more people submit responses, you know, once the Quidditch Club fills up, various other sheets are going to be created, and you will have a bunch of rosters. Now, I just mentioned that I was going to refactor things a little bit, and that's exactly what I'm going to do, because so much code is being duplicated here. We've got, how many lines is that? 11, that's almost 20 lines of code that are pretty much just doing the exact same thing over and over again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a, instead of a student name and email, I'm going to just call this student data. And I'm going to set this equal to an array. And that's going to have this e.values first index, and then the second index right in there. And then I can just change this to student data. And I don't have to copy those variables all over the place. All right, that's one simple change that we can do. And I can erase these student email there. Perfect. All right, but that really only got rid of one line of code here. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a choices array. and I'll space this out a little bit, and I'm gonna have in there, in that array, these named values elements, and I gotta change them to first choice, second choice, and third choice. Perfect. And now I've got one variable, just the choices variable. None of those first choice, second choice, third choice. And the choices array allows us to loop through there. So I'm going to create the standard for loop using that I to iterate less than choices.length. And then we're going to increment with the plus plus. And inside of here is where I'm going to take this code block, copy that in. Oh, messed up my indentation. I always like to fix that. And what I'm going to then do is group full. And then I want to change this to choices. And choices I. Sorry. It is getting late into the evening, so having a brain meltdown here. So the choices with the I iterator, we're gonna go ahead and replace all of the first choices with that. And all of this code here now becomes, we can go ahead and remove that. Perfect. So that got us down a little bit in code. And I believe that will work if isGroup full choices, but we don't want it to run. Like, so after it, this if the first time, if it's not full, I think we want to break out of this for loop completely. So I think we can then just put that break. If it is full, we can put the break there. And then that will prevent it from creating every single one. And then we've done a little bit of refactoring, kind of improved our sign-up sheet just a little bit. If you have any other suggestions for ways to improve this code, or you have any comments or questions, please comment below. Give me a subscribe and a like. Send me some feedback. I love hearing from teachers who are using this code to, you know, better their own practice and better the schools that they work for. So, cheers. Have a good night.